And in business, the International Monetary Fund has advised the Central Bank of Nigeria to unify the country's exchange rate system in order to avoid uncertainty in public and private sector decisions. The IMS advised on this at the unveiling of the World Economic Outlook report, which was released in Washington, D.C. on Tuesday. They also reiterated a need for the government to come up with measures to boost the non-oil revenue in order to spend more on social safety programs. The report, titled Global Manufacturing Downturn, Rising Trade Barriers, was unveiled by the IMF Economic Council, Councillor Jita Gopinath, and the Chief of the World Economic Studies Division of the IMF Research Department, Oya Selasson. According to the Councillor, per capita growth in Nigeria was weak, hence strong measures was needed to lift the growth into positive territory. She also noted that the need for structural reforms to address the weak per capita growth was necessary as well. Note that under the exchange rate system, the CBN has investors and exporters Forex window, the CBN official rate, the parallel market rate, the retail secondary market intervention sales, and the wholesale SMIS. Meanwhile, the United Nations Industrial Development Organization representative to ECOWAS and regional director at Nigeria Regional Office Hub, Jean Bakole, has said that the new UNIDO country program 2018 to 2022 would boost inclusive and sustainable industrial development in Nigeria. Bakole stated this during a courtesy visit and presentation of the new UNIDO Nigeria Country Program, CP, to Nigeria's former president, Olusegun Obasanjo, in Abeokuta. He also noted that this will contribute to the country's progress towards achieving the United Nations 2030 Agenda on Sustainable Development. The UNIDO representative to ECOWAS noted that the new CP, which was signed last year by the federal government of Nigeria and UNIDO, is the second in the series of UNIDO support to the government of Nigeria, which is targeted at enhancing the country's attempt to achieve inclusive and sustainable industrial development. According to him, the program comprises 9 programmatic components, which include industrial governance, research and statistics program, micro, small and medium enterprises development program, amongst others. And on the activities of the Nigerian Stock Exchange at the close of trade on Tuesday, the stock market recorded bearish sentiments with MTNN dropping by 0.16% to close at 26,513.65. Total deals recorded was 2,484, with an equity capitalization of 12.906 trillion naira. On the list of top gainers was CCNN, which closed at a share price value of 15 naira 85 kobo per share, while NACO closed at a share price value of 2 naira 45 kobo per share. On the list of top decliners was MTNN, which dropped to a share price value of 129 naira per share, while GlaxoSmith declined to a share price value of 6 naira 40 kobo per share. On the list of top trades by value was Guarantee, with a volume of 26.602 million shares traded at a value of 655.823 million naira. And in sectorial indices, NS Insurance was down 0.41%, NS Oil and Gas was down 0.22%, NS Banking was down 0.25%, NS Consumer Goods remained unchanged, and NS Industrial was up by 0.83%. In the Lagos parallel market, the Naira traded to the dollar at 358 Naira buying price and it traded at 360 Naira selling price. The Naira bought at 445 Naira to a British pound and traded at 450 Naira to a pound, while the Naira bought at 387 Naira to a euro and traded at 392 Naira to a euro.